I've been working with Caltrans since 1991. Almost that whole time has been here with the toll bridges in some way or another. I've also spent some time up in Sacramento design. My typical day, I oversee a group of engineers, roughly 20. We split it down to half of them are doing bridge inspections and the other half are doing rehabilitation designs for the older structures. A lot of the infrastructure here in the Bay Area, particularly the toll bridges, are now getting somewhere in the 50 years. You know, the Bay Bridge now is 70 years plus. So just trying to keep up with the everyday maintenance is a big issue as the infrastructure gets older and older. For me, the most exciting part, and I hate to say it, is when something goes wrong. I'm the type of person that likes to think fast, use my engineering background and my construction background, and try to determine repairs, you know, on the go. Some people run away from that kind of thing, you know, the pressure, but I seem to thrive off that kind of issue. So from my early years in high school, I always knew I wanted to either be an engineer or architect. I originally started studying architecture and realized that I didn't have that quick ability that when you look at an artist or someone that really has those talents, innate talents, that I probably wasn't, you know, going to make it as an architect. And I realized that pretty easy when I saw how quick people were putting the things together and how I struggled with it. Well, as far as school goes, you're paying your dues. It's just one step in your career. You know, you realize that you put in 4 or 5 years of education. It's what you get when you get out of school and what you can do. You know, engineering teach you logic, you know, common sense, you know, little things that most people take for granted. And you're hammered all through school, you know, to think. And the thinking part is a big part of your education, where you are taught how to think, how to solve problems. For me, you know, when I came out of high school and going into college right away, it wasn't the right way to go. And I took a couple years off. When I came back to it, I had a renewed vigor into the schooling part of it. You know, knew what I really wanted to do, knew that I wanted to do engineering now and could really focus on the demands of engineering. It's not an easy major to do. You sit around, look at all the liberal arts majors and they're out playing, you know, game volleyball and frisbee when you're up at 2 o'clock in the morning doing homework.